Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is reflection of light. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is light, we had completed the chapter, that is reflection of the light, students. And in this chapter, we had discussed the topics which includes the concave mirror, which includes that of the convex mirror also. Basically, the reflection of the light is concerned or is around that of the mirror concept only. And the reason for that, because the reflection can only occur in the mirror. Okay, reflection can occur only in the mirror. And reflection is what, student? Basically bouncing back of the light when it fall on the surface. And this bouncing back will only occur when the other surface is a polished surface. So we can say that reflection basically occurred at the mirror only, students. Okay, so in the case of a reflection, we have seen that what is a plane mirror, then we have seen that what is a spherical mirror. What are the different types of a spherical mirror are there, student? Basically, there are two type of a spherical mirror. One is a concave mirror, other one is the convex mirror. We have also seen that what kind of a reflection that we get after it, means in case of a convex and that of the concave mirror. We have seen that what are the different rules that we obtain through by keeping the position position of the object. It means the different rules which is important to understand that what happened when the object is kept at a certain position and what kind of a image will be formed there. Then the fourth one is fourth thing, students, that we have seen that not only this, what are the different positions of the object? It means where we should keep the object on that of the principal axis in order to get the image here, right? So we can say that the object, if it is kept at a different position on the principal axis, the image that will be also different. Even not only the position of the image, but also the nature and the size of the image will also vary. Okay, so we can say here that the object, position of the object and the position of the image totally depends upon each other. Image which will be formed, it can be real or it can be virtual. Okay, if image is formed behind that of the mirror, it will be virtual image, and if it is virtual, it is always erect, and if it is formed in front of the mirror, it is always real and inverted. Okay, so this is how we can say about the okay. We have also understood the mirror formula, student. Mirror formula is what? 1 by v plus 1 by u is equals to 1 by f. Here the object distance, image distance, here there is a sign convention that we used to give. Basically, whenever the object is kept at the left side of the mirror, any of the mirror, it can be concave or convex, it will be always taken as negative. Anything, either that of object or image or focal length, if it is at the left side, it will always negative. But if it is at behind that of the mirror, means at the right side, then it will be taken as positive. So because of that only, we can say that image object distance is always taken as negative, while the image distance is taken as a negative or positive depending upon that what kind of a image is formed there. Focal length is negative in case of a concave mirror, but positive in case of a convex mirror, because in case of a concave mirror, it is kept at the left side. In case of a convex mirror, it is kept as the right side. Moving on, students, and we will today start with the other portion of the light. So we had understood the reflection. Now we will going to understand the refraction of light. Refraction of light. So generally we used to say that light used to follow a straight path. Okay, light travels a straight path through this. So we can say here that a beam of a light is there, it is moving in a medium, and they always move in a medium with the same speed, and they move with the same path only. There is no changing, there is no bending of the movement in the rays occur, in that beam of a light occur. So this happens, this the beam of a light, they can easily move until and unless it is traveling in a same medium. Remember that. If it is moving in a different medium, then at that time, or from one medium to another medium, at that time it will not going to follow the same path, but there is some changes occur in that of the movement in the beam of the light. And this we will going to discuss in case of a refraction of the light, in which when the light move from one medium to the other medium, at that time there is some changes occur in that of the beam of light, students. So we can say here that is when light rays goes from one medium to another, then it goes obliquely. Obliquely, it means it get bent. Okay, it goes obliquely. So when the light rays go from one medium to the another, it bends obliquely, and this is called as refraction of light. This is called as refraction of light. Okay, this is called as refraction of light. So basically we can say, in a simple word, we can say that the bending of light rays from one medium to another, obliquely is called as refraction of light. This is called as refraction of light, students. Okay, so when the object, it moves from one medium to another, and the bending of the light ray happens here obliquely, that is called as the refraction of the light rays. Okay, so now what does that mean, students? That the light rays used to move from one medium to the other. It means, suppose light ray was moving in air. Okay, so at first the light rays are moving in air, and then suddenly it enters into water. Okay, then it enters water. So we can call it
air to water.
We can call it air to water medium. Air to water medium. So, air to water medium. So here, what happened? There is a change in the medium, occurs, student. Why is this so? Because air is what is comparatively rarer than that of water. So we can say that air is comparatively it is comparatively 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 so air is comparatively rarer than water, which is denser. Rarer means what, student? It means air is having less density than water. Air is having less density than water. Okay, so we can say here that since it is moving, so density differ, so obviously the medium changes, and when the medium changes, the movement also changes, means it get bend little bit. Okay, or this also happens, students, that the light ray, right now it is moving from the air itself and enter into a glass. Air. Then it enters into glass. So, we can call it air to glass medium. Air to glass medium. Now air is comparatively again rarer than glass. So reason is, since air is having less density than glass, it is having less density than glass. So it can be air to water or air to glass or water to glass or glass to water. Both can happen, student. Okay. So here one medium is rarer, one medium is denser. What is a rarer? You will use this terms a lot, student, when we will going to study in case of a refraction. Rare means what? The particles are less. And denser means what? The particles are more. So here the density of one of the medium is more than that of the other one. So we can say that one is denser and another one is the rarer one. Now what happened basically, if we want to understand that what kind of a changes happen. So I said that when the light rays moves from one medium to the other medium, at that time there is a change in the movement, change in the direction of the movement of the light rays. So you can see here, students, suppose this is what? This is a kind of a separating media. Okay? So we can say that suppose we have taken a glass slab. Okay? This is a glass slab. Glass slab is what? Basically it is made up of a glass itself. Now what happened? This is the glass. So we can say here that this one is the glass, student. And this one is what? This is the air. And this one is also air. what we have to say, what we have to understand, we said that when a light wave moves from one medium to another, it bends. Okay, so how it bends? Suppose a light ray falls on its surface. Falls on its surface. A light ray falls on its surface. Now what happened? This is the normal. We know that whenever a light ray falls on a surface, a perpendicular line to that of the glass, to that of the medium is that of the normal. So this is what, this is the incident light, incident, which is represented by I. We know that this is an incident one. So if suppose this is A and this is O, so this will be, and this is what, this is N and this is N dash. So the angle made between O, A, O, N is, it will be equals to angle I, which we call as angle of incidence. Now, it hit the normal, students. It hit the normal. So, after coming to the, now it enters into the glass. Now, what happened? It will not remain the same. It will not going to move as it is after it came from the air, because we know that now the medium get changed. So what happened? It will bend towards that of the normal. It bends towards that of the normal. Now it will be what? It will be B. So angle of reflection will be equals to AO, this is N dash. BO N dash will be angle of reflection. Now you can see here, student, one thing, that when it moves from rarer to denser, it get bend towards the normal. Okay. So here you have seen here one thing, and that is, we know that in the first case, that is when we were talking about the reflection of light, at that time we said that angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is always equals to angle of reflection. So we can say here that since the angle, since here it is not moving at as it is, but it get bent towards the normal. So now the angle of that of incidence is not equals to angle of refraction. Remember that, student, here we called it, because this is an angle made by the incident ray and the normal. So it is angle of incidence. And since this is a angle which is made up of, which is made by, I'm writing it here. So this is an angle which is made by that of the BON dash, that is by the refracted ray and the normal. So it is called as angle of refraction, not reflection. It is refraction. Okay, refraction. So this is called as the angle of refraction. So one is incident and one is the, another is the refraction. Now we are going to study the refraction instead of reflection. So we knew that in case of a reflection of light, that angle of incidence, that is angle I, is equals to angle of reflection. But here in this case it is really not like that. Just here, you know that it get bent towards that of the normal. So the angle of incidence is not equal to angle of refraction. So the angle of incidence is not equal to the angle of refraction. Angle of incidence is not equals to the angle of refraction, students. Okay, now see here. So angle of incidence is not equals to angle of refraction. So here the second law of reflection does not follow. Okay, Now the question arises that why there is a cause, means what is the cause of the refraction of a light, student? Why the medium, it get, means due to the change in the medium, the light rays get bent towards that of the mirror or moves away from that of the normal. So the reason is what happened here, the speed of the light, it changes, it is different. Speed of the light is not constant. You know that the speed of the light in the air, in the vacuum, in the glass, in the water, it is totally different. In case of air, it is 3 into 10 the power 8 meter per second. In case of a glass, it is 2 into 10 the power 8 meter per second. So you can see here the speed is different, and due to the change in the speed, in case of a glass it is less, in case of a water it is more than that of the glass, in case of a air or vacuum it is more, very much a speed it is having, and because of the speed only there is a change in the, there is a, the movement of that of the light falling on the surface get changed after falling on it, it get refracted instead of moving with the same line. Okay, so we can say here that the speed of the light is different in different media. The speed of the light is different in different media. For example, speed of light in air is equals to 3 into 10 the power 8 meter per second. Speed of light in glass is equals to 2 into 10 the power 6 meter per second. So because of the change in the speed, they used to show this movement. It means since the speed is different in different medium, so when they move from one medium to another, such kind of a bending can be seen. Okay, so we can say here that due to different speed of light in different media, speed of light in different media, so speed of light in different media, so they show the refraction. What does that mean? Higher will be the speed. Okay, higher will be the difference in the speed or density. Higher will be the difference in the speed of two media. Speed of two media, higher will be the speed of the two media, higher will be the refraction. Higher will be the refraction. So higher will be the difference in the speed of the two media, higher will be the refraction. Okay. Now, why such change can be seen easily? Basically, what happened? So, why the change in the speed? Why the change in speed of light? Change in speed of light causes refraction of light. Why the change in the speed of light causes refraction of light. Okay. So the change in the speed of the light causes the refraction of the light. The reason is, students, what happened basically, suppose this is a glass. Okay. Now, when a beam of a light, when suppose we take a beam of a light, so this is the whole, the beam of a light is coming along with it. So suppose we have taken the two. So these two beam of a light, or this consisting of a lot of other light also, students. Suppose this is what? This is A, O, this is B and C. So what happened? This light rays here, since it is falling obliquely to that of the glass slab, to that of the other media, so this is what? This will reaches first and this will reaches little later. You can see here, if this is the glass slab, so this will reaches first and this will have to cover a distance up to here. Basically, you can understand by this that it reaches to that of the glass slab very easily, means earlier than that of the ray which is falling on that of the surface of a glass little later. So what happened after that? It will get reflected like this. And then again it will goes back like this, students. So what happened? Whoever reaches first, which one will reach first? So you will find that since this will reaches first to that of the glass slab, so after that it will also exit through that of the glass slab with a high speed. So the reason is, since it is falling obliquely, if it will fall directly, then we will not going to see such kind of a change, or such kind of a refraction cannot be seen easily. But since it is coming obliquely from one of the direction, it is coming at a, making an angle with that of the normal, students. So one of the portion of the beam of the light reaches late and one of will fall early. So whoever will fall early will enter into the glass slab, and the speed, again it is less only. Now it will reaches first with that of the other end of the glass slab, and it emerges first out from that of the glass slab to the air. Here the other one, since it reaches late to that of the glass slab, so after refraction it will reaches late to the other end of the glass slab, and finally it will goes, or it emerges out, student. So basically this happens, this refraction, speed of the light, it changes, what is the cause of the speed of the light changes and why it is responsible for showing the refraction. So whoever which is having the speed, higher speed, it will reaches to the glass slab earlier, finally the speed get lowers down and it emerges out. So whichever will reaches first will goes first itself. Okay. So since it is falling obliquely, that is why there is such kind of a change that we can see here. We can say, students, that is light waves reach the glass first. And here, light waves reach the glass, reaches the glass. Later. Okay.